एवरीवन, आई एम योर मैथ्स टीचर लखन सर फ्रॉम साइंस एकेडमी डॉ. सो स्टूडेंट, इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर नेक्स्ट चैप्टर दैट इज क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन. ओके, सो इन प्रीवियस वीडियो दैट मींस इन द सेकेंड चैप्टर वी हैड ऑलरेडी डिस्कस डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ पॉलीनोमियल्स. सो द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ पॉलीनोमियल्स व्हिच आर बेस्ड ऑन डिग्री आर लीनियर पॉलीनोमियल, क्वाड्रेटिक पॉलीनोमियल एंड द cubic polynomial. So here linear polynomial means what? If the degree of the polynomial is 1, then it is called as the linear polynomial. But how to decide the degree of the polynomial? So degree is nothing but the maximum power of the given expression. Dilele expression chi ji ka maximum power asel ti asel apli degree of the polynomial. This is how we are finding the degree of the given polynomial. So for quadratic polynomial, the highest power or the maximum power is 2. That means if the degree of the polynomial is 2, then it is called as the quadratic polynomial. And when we equate this quadratic polynomial to 0, then it is called as a quadratic equation. So as we know that for quadratic polynomial, degree is 2 and its standard form of quadratic polynomial is ax square plus bx plus c, where most important condition is a is not equals to 0. That means the value of a is not becomes 0. Why? Because if value of a becomes 0, the h value 0 jali, then the first expression a 0 into x square becomes 0, and then we get only bx plus c. So here for the given expression or for the given polynomial, maximum power is 1. That's why it is not a quadratic polynomial. So for quadratic polynomial, the most important condition is value of a is not equals to 0. This is the standard form for the quadratic polynomial. And okay, so when we equate this quadratic polynomial, and ज्या वेळेस आपण हा quadratic polynomial equate to 0 करणार आहोत, then it becomes a quadratic equation. So ax square plus bx plus c equate to 0, then we get a quadratic equation, right? So we all know that what is equation? If the given expression contains equality sign, then it is called as a equation, right? Before equality sign, it is just a polynomial or expression. But when we equate this polynomial or expression to 0, then we get a quadratic equation. So here also important condition is a is not equals to 0. So this is the standard form of a quadratic equation. Ax square plus bx plus c is equals to 0, where a is not equals to 0, right? So when we equate quadratic polynomial to 0, then we get a quadratic equation. So the standard form for a quadratic equation is ax square plus bx plus c is equals to 0. Okay, this is what our standard form for the quadratic equation. And the important condition for the quadratic equation is a is not equals to 0. That means value of a not becomes 0. That means coefficient of x square is not 0. Okay, now the next point which is important for us, how to decide whether the given equation is a quadratic equation or not, right? So the standard form for a quadratic equation is ax square plus bx plus c is equals to 0, where a is not equals to 0. Okay, so here a, b, c are the coefficients, right? And a is not equals to 0. Okay, so to check given equation is a quadratic or not, for that there are three conditions. First one is contains equality sign. That means without equal to sign, it is not a equation. जो पर्यंत equal to sign involve होणार नाही, तो पर्यंत equation मिळणार नाही. Second one, degree is 2, that means the maximum power or the maximum index of the given equation is 2. Maximum power is compulsory kithe have aplyala 2. And third one, that is use only one variable, that is also important for us, because in previous chapter we had discussed linear equation in how many variables, in 2 variables. Here in quadratic equation we are using only one variable. So to check out whether the given equation is a quadratic or not, for that there are 3 conditions: contains equality sign, maximum power is 2, that means degree 2, and third one, use only one variables. Okay, these are the 3 conditions to check out whether the given equation is quadratic or not. Okay, now to solve quadratic equation there are 3 methods we have to see in this chapter. First one is factorization method, second one is completing the square method, and third one is the formula method. These are the 3 methods to find the solution or the roots of a given quadratic equation. Okay, before that we take some examples to check out whether they are quadratic or not. Okay, so the first example is x minus 2 whole square plus 1 is equals to x minus 3. Okay, first of all simplify the given equation. For that, x minus 2 whole square is nothing but a minus b whole square. So x square minus 4x plus 4, a square minus 2ab plus b square plus 1 is equals to 2x minus 3. Now collect the like terms, minus 4x, this plus 2x goes to the opposite side, so we get minus 2x. 4 plus 1 5, this minus 3 goes to the left side, so we get plus 3, and then left side la karel fakta 0, because all the terms are goes to the left side, so the right hand side la fakta karel apni 0. Finally we get x square minus 6x plus 8 is equals to 0. Okay, that means the given equation is in the form, dilele final equation konacha form one is in the form ax square plus bx plus c is equals to 0. Here x is the only one variable, contains equality sign, and maximum power is 2. So given equation is in the form ax square plus bx plus c is equals to 0. This is the standard form for the quadratic equation. Therefore given equation is a quadratic. Therefore given equation is a quadratic equation. This is how we are checking given equation is quadratic or not. Let's take one another example. X in bracket x plus 1 plus 8 is equals to x plus 2 into x minus 2. First of all simplify the equation. For that multiply x into x plus 1, so we get x into x, x square, x into 1, x plus 8 is equals to, this is multiplication of binomial with binomial, right? So x into x, x square, x into minus 2, minus 2x, 2 into x, plus 2x, 2 into minus 2, that is minus 4. Now collect the like terms. So x square, this x square goes to the left side, so we get minus x square plus x, minus 2x plus 2x get cancelled, plus 8 plus 4 is equals to 0. So we get here x square get cancelled, but remaining terms are x plus 12 is equals to 0. Okay, so here the given equation, the above equation x plus 12 is equals to 0 is not in the form, when the form is not in the form ax square plus bx plus c is equals to 0. Therefore it is not a quadratic equation. म्हणून ते इक्वेशन क्वाड्रेटिक आहे का? देअरफॉर इट इज नॉट ए क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन. व्हाय? बिकॉज मॅक्झिमम पॉवर ऑफ द गिवन इक्वेशन इज नॉट टू, इट इज वन. देअरफॉर इट इज नॉट ए क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन. ओके, सो दीज आर द टू इम्पॉर्टंट पॉइंट फॉर अस. दॅट इज फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज व्हॉट इज द स्टँडर्ड फॉर्म ऑफ ए क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन. ax square plus bx plus c is equals to 0. That means, and most important condition is a is not equals to 0, where a, b, c are the coefficient of x square, b and c. C is the constant term. And last one, a is not equals to 0. Okay, and to check whether the given equation is a quadratic or not, for that check three conditions. Equality sign, use only one variable, and last one, the maximum power is 2. Then the given equation is a quadratic equation. Now, we are solving the exercise 4.1. Now, we are starting the exercise 4.1. First question is, check whether the following are quadratic equations. Okay. The khali ka aplyala equations dilele, te aplyala check out karayche whether they are quadratic or not. Okay. So, from question number first, we solve only four questions. That is question number first, third, seventh and eighth. Remaining or homework. Okay, so the first equation is x plus 1 whole square is equals to 2 in bracket x minus 3. First of all, simplify it. Okay, so we know that x plus 1 whole square is nothing but a plus b whole square. So we get x square plus 2x plus 1 is equals to 2x minus 6. Multiply 2 by this bracket, so we get 2x minus 6. Now collect the like terms, so we get x square plus 2x. This plus 2x goes to the left side, that is minus 2x plus 1 plus 6 is equals to 0. Minus 6 goes to the left side. And finally, we get x square, so plus 2x minus 2x, it cancel, 7 is equals to 0. That means we get given equation is in the form x square plus 0x plus 7 is equals to 0. Here, the middle term is absent, that is coefficient of x is absent, so we write it as a 0x. Therefore, above equation is in the form ax square plus bx plus c is equals to 0. Contains equality sign, use only one variable and the maximum power is 2. That means above equation is in the form ax square plus bx plus c is equals to 0. Therefore, it is a quadratic equation. म्हणून ते काय आहे? क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन आहे. ओके, नाउ थर्ड इक्वेशन इज x मायनस 2 x प्लस 1 इज इक्वल्स टू x मायनस 1 इंटू x प्लस 3. ओके, हियर वी हॅव टू सॉल्व बायनोमियल विथ बायनोमियल अँड बायनोमियल विथ बायनोमियल. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल सिम्प्लिफाइड, सो वी गेट x इंटू x, x square, x into 1, x minus 2 into x, minus 2x, minus 2 into 1, minus 2 is equals to x into x, x square, x into 3, 3x, minus 1 into x, minus x, minus 3. Now, collect the like terms. So, we get here x square get cancelled. Why? Because this x square goes to the left side. So, we get x square minus x square. So, we get cancelled. So, x minus 2x. Minus x, 3x minus x, 2x. And this plus 2x goes to the opposite side, that is minus 2x minus 2 plus 3 is equals to 0. And finally, we get minus 3x plus 1 is equals to 0. That means the above equation is not in the form ax square plus bx plus c is equals to 0. That means here the maximum power is 1. Therefore, the above equation is not in the form ax square plus bx plus c equals to 0. Therefore, it is not a quadratic equation. म्हणून ते quadratic equation नाही. Now, equation number 7 is x plus 2 cube is equals to 2x in bracket x square minus 1. First of all, simplify the given equation. For that, we require one formula, that is a plus b होल क्यूब. व्हाट इज ए प्लस बी होल क्यूब इज नथिंग बट ए क्यूब प्लस बी क्यूब प्लस थ्री ए स्क्वायर बी प्लस थ्री ए बी स्क्वायर. सो ऑल दीज आइडेंटिटीज आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर अस. सो हियर ए क्यूब दैट इज एक्स क्यूब प्लस बी क्यूब दैट इज एट, टू क्यूब इज टू, सो टू क्यूब इज एट. नाउ 3a square b, 3 into a square that is x square into b that is 2 plus 3 into ab square that is 4 is equals to 2x into x cube. 2x into x square is nothing but 2x cube minus 2x. Now collect the like terms. So we get x cube plus 3 to the 6 into 6x square, 3 4 is 12x plus 8 is equals to 2x cube minus 2x. Okay. Now collect the like terms. Then we get x cube minus 2x cube plus 6x square plus 12x plus 2x plus 8 equals to 0. And finally, we get minus x cube plus 6x square plus 14x plus 8 is equals to 0. So here, the above equation is not in the form. One form of the name is not in the form ax square plus bx plus c is equals to 0. Why? Because here the maximum power is 3 and for quadratic equation we require maximum power 2. That's why the given equation is also not a quadratic equation. Therefore, it is not a quadratic equation. Okay. And finally, the last equation from the first question is x cube minus 4x square minus x plus 1 is equals to x minus 2 whole cube. Here, apalala, first of all, we have to simplify this. Okay. So, we are simplifying it. That is x cube minus 4x square minus x plus 1 is equals to, that is a minus b whole cube. So the a minus b whole cube is nothing but a cube minus b cube, right? Minus 3ab square plus 3ab square. That means, remember this identity, a minus b whole cube is nothing but a cube minus 3a square b plus 3ab square minus b cube. This is the identity for a minus b whole cube. Okay, now we are applying here. So here a is nothing but the x and 2 is nothing but the b. So the a cube that is x cube minus 3a square b. So 3a square x square 2, so 3 to the 6 x square plus 3ab square, so 3 into x into 2 square, that is 4 3s are 12 x, and finally minus b cube, that is 2 cube is cube of 2 is 8. Now collect the like terms. After collecting, so first of all eliminate x cube because this plus x cube goes to the left side, so you get x cube minus x cube, so that's why they are cancelling. Now 4x square, this minus 6x square goes to the left side, so we get plus 6x square minus x. This plus 12x goes to the left side, so we get minus 12x plus 1 plus 8 equals to 0. And finally, minus plus plus, so we get 2x square minus 13x. Minus minus get plus, so minus 13x plus 9 is equals to 0. So the above equation is in the form, one the form of the ax square plus bx plus c is equals to 0 because it contains equality sign using only one variable as x. The maximum power is 2, that's why it is a quadratic equation. This is how we're checking whether the given equation is quadratic or not. This is the first question from exercise 4.5. Now, question number second is, represent the following situations in the form of quadratic equation. Okay. इथे आपल्याला काही वर्ड प्रॉब्लेम गिवन आहे. हियर वी आर गिवन अ वर्ड प्रॉब्लेम्स, वी हॅव टू कन्वर्ट दिस इन्फॉर्मेशन इन द फॉर्म ऑफ क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन. ओके, सो लाईक इन लिनियर इक्वेशन इन टू व्हेरिएबल ऑल्सो वी हॅव डिस्कस सम वर्ड प्रॉब्लेम्स अँड कन्वर्ट देम इन टू अ फॉर्म ऑफ लिनियर फॉर्म. सो हियर ऑल्सो वी हॅव टू कन्वर्ट दिस इन्फॉर्मेशन इन टू अ क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन. आपल्याला आता ह्या इन्फॉर्मेशनला क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशनच्या फॉर्म मध्ये रिप्रेझेंट करायचं. Last, we have discussed how to check whether the given equation is quadratic or not. For that, there are three conditions. Equality sign, using only one variable. This is the important point for our word problems. And the maximum power is 2. Okay. That means, to form a quadratic equation from the given information, we have to use only one variable. इथे आपल्याला फक्त एकाच व्हेरिएबलचा यूज करायचा आहे. ओके, सो लेट्स चेक how to convert this situation in the form of quadratic equation. So the first problem is, or the first situation is, the area of rectangular plot is 528 meter square. The length of the plot is one more than twice its breadth. We need to find the length and breadth of the plot. Okay, so here we know that how to find the area of rectangle. So area of rectangle is nothing but the length and breadth. But area is given, that is 528. But how to find length and breadth? Because here we are not use two variables, that is x and y. Here we have to use only one variable. That means in word problems of a quadratic equations, one thing is depends on the another. इथे एक गोष्ट ही दुसऱ्यावरती depend असेल. That means check out in the problem, the length of the plot is one more than twice its breadth. That means her length is depends on the breadth. That means without breadth we cannot find the length. So her length is depends on the breadth. That's why we are considering the breadth of the rectangular first as a x. Okay, now we get the breadth of a rectangle as a x. So how to find the length? So length of the plot is one more than, that is plus 1, than twice its breadth. Twice 2, breadth किती आहे x, that is the length of the rectangular plot is 2x plus 1. Now we know the formula to find the area of rectangle is nothing but length into breadth. So we know the area, now we know the length as well as breadth. Put all these things in the formula, then we get a quadratic equation. So here, remember one thing, in word problems of a quadratic equation, one thing is depends on the another, because we have to use only one variable. सो जी गोष्ट दुसऱ्यावरती डिपेंड असेल, ज्याच्यावरती डिपेंड आहे त्याला कन्सिडर करा. सो हियर लेट ब्रेड्थ ऑफ रेक्टेंगुलर प्लॉट बी एक्स मीटर, बिकॉज लेंथ इज डिपेंड्स ऑन द ब्रेड्थ. दॅट्स वाय वी आर कन्सिडरिंग ब्रेड्थ फर्स्ट. देअरफॉर नाउ वी गेट लेंथ ऑफ प्लॉट, that is 1 meter more than twice its breadth, that is 2x plus 1 meter. So we know that what area of rectangle, that is area of rectangular plot is equals to length into breadth. So what is the area of rectangular plot? Is nothing but the 528. What is the length of the plot? That is twice x plus 1. And finally, what is the breadth? That is x. Now simplify the equation. So we get 528 is equals to x into 2x, 2x square plus x into 1, x. Now write in standard form, that is in the form of ax square plus bx plus c is equals to 0. Let me write all the terms at one place. So we get 2x square plus x, this plus 528 goes to the right side, so we get minus 528 is equals to 0. This is the representation of a given situation. in the form of quadratic. So the length and breadth of a rectangular plot satisfies the equation 2x square plus x minus 520 is equals to 0. This is the representation of a given situation in the form of quadratic equation. Why it is a quadratic equation? Because it contains equality sign using only one variable and the maximum power is 2. Therefore, it is a quadratic equation. Finally, write down. After I find out, we have to find the length and breadth. So, write down the statement as length and breadth of plot satisfies the equation 2x square plus x minus 528 is equals to 0. Okay. This is how we are representing the given situation in the form of quadratic equation. Now, check out the second example from the question number second is the product of two consecutive positive integers is 306. Okay. Then we need to find the integers. आता इथे आपल्याला integers find out करायचे आहेत. According to given condition, आपल्याला product घ्यायचे आहे. कोणाचा? Two consecutive positive integers. So the consecutive means what? Comes after one another. म्हणजे एक नंतर काय येतो? After one, it comes two. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 are the consecutive positive integers. Okay. That means to find the next integer, we're adding 1 to the previous one, then we get the next, that is 7. That means, but product of two consecutive, me ithe konte don ahet, first positive integer kay consider karnar. So the value of second positive integer is depends on the first. So that's why we are considering the first positive integer as x, then we get second positive integer as x plus 1, right? So let 2 consecutive positive integers be x and x plus 1. Now we get 2 consecutive positive integers. Now take its product. So therefore, from given condition mane kay sanje product ghaycha hai. Kunacha? X and x plus 1 and the product is 306. Now simplify the given equation, so we get x square plus x, this plus 306 goes to the left side, so we get minus 306 is equals to 0. So the given equation is a quadratic equation. Why? It contains equality sign using only one variable and the maximum power is 2. So the two consecutive positive integer satisfies the equation x square plus x minus 306 equals to 0. This is the representation of given situation in the form of quadratic equation. So, two consecutive positive integers satisfies the equation x square plus x minus 306 equals to 0. This is the representation of given situation in the form of quadratic. Okay. Now we are going to solve the last example from the exercise. Third is for homework. Now the last question from question number second is, a train travels a distance of 480 km at uniform speed. Okay. If the speed had been 8 km per hour less, then it would have taken 3 hours more to cover the same distance. We need to find the speed of the train here. Okay. This is the speed of the train find out. What is the information? A train travels a distance of 480 km at uniform speed. Okay. Here we need to find speed. Okay. And according to second condition, if the speed had been 8 km per hour less, okay, then it will have taken 3 hours more to cover the same distance. Okay. So, in the second condition, also we have to cover 480 km distance, but here speed of the train is 8 km per hour less. Okay. पहिल्यापेक्षा स्पीड कितीने कमी करणार आहे आपण 8 किलोमीटर ने. बट फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी नीड टू फाइंड द स्पीड ऑफ द ट्रेन. सो लेट द स्पीड ऑफ द ट्रेन बी एक्स. ओके, देन इन सेकंड कंडिशन इफ स्पीड इज 8 किलोमीटर पर आवर लेस, स्पीड कितीने कमी होणार आता 8 किलोमीटर, दॅट इज एक्स मायनस 8, then it would have taken 3 hours more than the previous. Okay, 3 hours more to cover the same distances. Then we need to find the speed of the train. So suppose initial speed of the train x, let the speed of the train x, then new speed ka asel tumcha x minus 8, why? Because it is 8 kilometer per hour less. Second condition madhe the speed ka anar tumcha kami honar aahe, manjech ज्यावेळेस टाइम टेकन बाय ट्रेन टू ट्रॅव्हल 480 किलोमीटर ऍट स्पीड ऑफ एक्स मायनस 8 किलोमीटर पर आवर, हे काय असणार आहे जास्त. म्हणजे इथे तुम्हाला स्पीड टाइम काय लागणार आहे जास्त. मग फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल फाइंड द टाइम फॉर सेकंड कंडिशन अँड टाइम फॉर द फर्स्ट कंडिशन, आणि ह्या दोघांची ज्यावेळेस तुम्ही सबट्रॅक्शन करताल ती किती असणार आहे आपली 3, बिकॉज इट टेक्स 3 hours मोर टू ट्रॅव्हल द सेम डिस्टन्स दॅन द फर्स्ट कंडिशन. फर्स्ट कंडिशन मध्ये तुम्हाला जो काही टाइम लागणार आहे त्याच्यापेक्षा 3 hours जास्त टाइम कुठे लागणार आहे इन द सेकंड कंडिशन. वाय? बिकॉज इट टेक 8 किलोमीटर पर आवर लेस स्पीड. इथे स्पीड कितीने कमी होणार आहे 8 किलोमीटर पर आवर. स्पीड कमी झाला तर लागणारा टाइम काय असेल तुमचा जास्त असणार आहे. ओके, सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी नीड टू कन्सिडर स्पीड ऑफ द ट्रेन. लेट speed of train be x kilometer per hour. Therefore, new speed is x minus 8 kilometer per hour. Ata navin speed ka hai? X minus 8 kilometer per hour, because the speed had been 8 km per hour less than the previous. Okay. If the speed of train is x km per hour, then how much time it takes to reach 480 km? They find out kara. And if speed is had been less by 8 km per hour to travel 480 km, for that also find time and make subtraction of both of them, and it is a 3 hours, because it is in second case, if speed decreases by 8 km, then it takes 3 hours more. So, find time taken by train to travel 480 km distances. Time taken by train to travel 480 km distances by speed x km per hour is, so we know that time is nothing but the distance upon speed. So the distance is 480 km, for the speed is x, and if speed decreases by 8 km per hour, then time taken by train is time and distance upon speed. So in second condition also we have to travel 480 km distance, but here speed is x minus 8, that is speed had been decreases by 8 km per hour, and it takes 3 hours more. Therefore, आता from given condition, आता तुम्हाला दोन्ही condition मध्ये time माहिती आहे. From given condition, in second condition it takes 3 hours more than the first. Second condition मध्ये if we have to travel 480 km by x minus 8 km per hour, then it takes 3 hours more. So subtract time of first condition from the second condition. So time for the first condition is 480 upon x, and time for the second condition is 480 upon x minus 8, and it takes more time to travel, and their subtraction is 3, because it takes 3 hours जब सेकेंड कंडीशन द टाइम टू फर्स्ट कंडीशन में सब्ट्रैक्ट करता है, इट टेक्स हाउ मेनी आवर्स टू मोर, 3 आवर्स. नाउ सॉल्व दिस इक्वेशन, डिवाइड बाय 480, सो वी गेट 1 अपॉन x माइनस 8, 1 अपॉन x इज इक्वल टू 3 अपॉन 480 डिवाइड बाय 480. And finally we get 1 upon x minus 8 is equal minus 1 upon x is equals to 1 upon 160. Now we have to make subtractions to perform cross multiplication. So x minus x plus 8 divided by x square minus 8x is equals to 1 upon 60. Plus x minus x get cancelled. So we get x square minus 8x is equals to 8 into 160. And finally, we get x square minus 8x minus 16 is 128 and finally 0. Okay. This is the required quadratic equation for the given situation. So, speed of the train x satisfies the given equation. X square minus 8x minus 128 equals to 0. This is the representation of given situation in the form of quadratic equation. So we are completing the practice set or exercise 4.1, which is based on standard form of the quadratic equation and how to represent the given word problems or the given situation in the form of quadratic equation. So last one thing which is important for us, we have to solve all the problems from the exercise 4.1 for the homework. Last thing which is important for us, stay home, stay safe and keep practicing.